Hello everyone, we have completed first unit, that is conduction. Now let us start heat exchangers. Heat exchangers are generally used in case of power plant, RAC and automobiles. These are very much important equipments. So it is very much important for us to understand what exactly is heat exchanger, what happens inside the heat exchanger. Okay, let us say there are two fluids, one is hot fluid and other is cold fluid, and we want to exchange the heat between these two fluids so that our cycle is continuous, so that to continue our cycle. Okay, if let us say the hot fluid is coming in this direction and going out, similarly a cold fluid also coming in and going out. During this process we will have some arrangement here such that there is heat transfer from the hot fluid to that of a cold fluid, such that the temperature of the hot fluid decreases and the temperature of the cold fluid increases. Heat exchangers is a steady flow adiabatic open system in which two flowing fluids exchange or transfer heat between them without losing or gaining heat to ambient. There is no heat loss to ambient, that is Q out is zero. Whatever be the heat loss of the hot fluid is equal to the heat gain in the cold fluid. Therefore it is easier for us to write the heat balance equation. Therefore heat loss by the hot fluid is equal to heat gain by the cold fluid is the basic equation in case of heat exchangers. Okay, let us see some examples of heat exchanger. Surface condenser. Condensers are generally used to decrease the temperature of the fluid. Let us say we have the steam. Temperature of steam is generally higher than that of the water. Therefore, to decrease the temperature of the steam, it is sent into a shell and tube type of heat exchanger. This is called a shell. The outer one, which is a hollow one, is a shell. And inside the shell, there will be some pipes through which a cold fluid flows, so that as soon as the hot fluid is coming, in that same time cold fluid is also flowing inside these pipes. Therefore the heat transfer will take place and the condensation will start on the pipes. Therefore it is called as surface, since on the surface of the pipes condensation is taking place, it is called as surface condenser. This steam is further converted into the water and is collected here. This is called a condensate. Some other examples of heat exchangers are economizer, superheater, air preheater, cooling tower. Economizers, superheaters and air preheaters are called as boiler accessories. This is very much important. Sometimes one more question will directly ask you from this. Which of the following are the boiler accessories? Economizer, superheater and air preheater. What are they? Let us say we have a steam power plant which is running on modified Rankine cycle. Therefore the cycle would be like this. Okay, this is the cycle and this is the turbine inlet, turbine exit, this is the condenser and this is the entry to the feed pump. After feed pump it will be at this point, and this is boiler area. This one is the boiler area. Now before reaching to the boiler area, whatever be the heat is supplied to our feed water, that is supplied in with the help of economizer, where the hot fluid gases will be flowing. With this hot fluid gases will increase the temperature of the feed water which exit from the feed pump, therefore reduces the work of the boiler. Therefore it will helps in increasing the thermal efficiency of the boiler. Okay, after reaching this point boiler will start its work. Therefore it will boiler will convert the liquid, saturated liquid, into a saturated vapor. From here again the flue gases will be flowing, again a hot high temperature flue gases will be flowing, which further increases the temperature of the steam, that is dry saturated steam. Therefore here superheaters are installed here, economizers are installed here, boiler is here. So here it is economizer, it is boiler, superheaters. Okay, Air preheater is used before sending, let us say this is the combustion chamber, air is supplied to the combustion chamber. This air is preheated before supplying to the combustion chamber so that the efficiency of the boiler is increased. Understand, this is some what is happening inside the boiler. What is happening? Phase change is taking place. To change the phase, we need heat. Therefore, we have to supply the heat to the boiler. We will supply the heat to the boiler from the combustion chamber. For combustion chamber to burn, we need air as well as fuel. Therefore, whatever be the air that is supplied to the combustion chamber, that air is first passed through the air preheater so that the temperature of the air increases. Therefore, the thermal efficiency of the boiler increases. How this air preheater got heat? This will also use the flue gases. Okay. What are flue gases? Flue gases are those which are exhaust of this combustion chamber, which if we not use, that has to be expelled to the atmosphere, which is not that much efficient. Therefore, we utilize that flue gases to increase the efficiency of the boiler. Okay, let us see the fifth one, that is cooling tower. Cooling tower is used to decrease the temperature of the condenser water. Let us say you have the condenser here. There is a condenser here. We have installed an heat exchanger. Condenser is there. We have installed a heat exchanger here, and this heat exchanger will have inlet, some inlet and some outlet. The outlet of this heat exchanger, which is having higher temperature, is sent inside this condenser through a spray nozzle. This high temperature water is sprayed inside this cooling tower. In the meanwhile, a cool air is supplied from the outside using fan. We call it as draught fans. Cold air is supplied by which a heat transfer will take place. Here the cooling tower is of direct contact type, because a spray nozzle, water spray as well as the cold air are mixing directly. Therefore, this can comes under a direct contact type of heat exchanger. Okay, after cooling, this water is again sent to the heat exchanger. Okay, the purpose of cooling tower is to reduce the temperature of the condenser water. Let us apply the first law of thermodynamics to heat exchangers. If you remember, the for open system we have steady flow energy equation, which is H1 plus C1 square by 2000 plus GZ1 by 1000 plus Q is equal to H2 plus C2 square by 2000 plus GZ2 by 1000 plus W. This can simply be written like this. We have taken the entire H1 C1 square by 2000 and GZ1 by 1000 to the right side, and we have bring the work to the left side. Therefore, Q minus W is equal to delta H plus delta KE plus delta PE. Since in heat exchangers there is no loss of heat to the surrounding, therefore the change in enthalpy of the entire heat exchanger is same. Therefore, the net change in enthalpy of heat exchanger is equal to zero. Further, which we can write is as change in enthalpy of a hot fluid is plus change in enthalpy of a cold fluid is equal to zero, which further can be written as rate of decrease in enthalpy of a hot fluid is equal to rate of increase in the enthalpy of a cold fluid, that is m dot cph into thi minus the minus m dot cpc tce minus tci. Remember one thing, thi is greater than the, tce greater than tci, because the temperature of the cold fluid is increasing and temperature of the hot fluid is decreasing. One more thing here, we have considered CP not CC, because we assume that in heat exchanger the pressure remains constant. Pressure is constant. Okay, this is very much important assumption. One more thing to note is that you should not use this equation when one of the fluid is changing its state. Let us say there is a heat exchanger installed here. one of the fluid which is a hot fluid is at constant temperature T is changing its phase. Meanwhile, the whole fluid is increasing its temperature. This is TCE. Therefore, you have to use only this formula to find out what is the heat transfer taking place. You should not use this formula, okay? Because with this you will get zero, which is not our case, okay? To get whatever be the heat that is supplied to the cold fluid, use this formula. In case the hot fluid is changing its phase, in case the cold fluid is changing its phase, use this formula instead of this, okay? Depending on the process involved, the heat exchangers are classified like this: direct transfer type of heat exchanger, direct contact type of heat exchanger, storage or regenerative type of heat exchanger. Direct transfer type of heat exchangers, these are those both hot fluid and cold fluid do not have any physical contact between them, but heat transfer occurs between them. There is a heat transfer between the cold fluid and hot fluid, but there is no physical contact between them. Okay, examples are economizers, superheaters, surface condensers, oil coolers. I have explained you already this economizers, superheaters. You can easily understand what will happen. There will be a pipe carrying water and there will be some shell through which a steam enters. Therefore, there is no direct contact between the steam and water. There is a separating wall, that is pipe wall. Therefore, we can take it under the consideration that this is a direct transfer type of heat exchanger, but not the direct contact type of heat exchanger. Okay, let us see what is the direct contact type of heat exchanger. Here both hot and cold fluid mix up with each other and exchange heat. Example of direct contact type of heat exchanger I have already explained you, that is cooling tower. Now, what is regenerative or storage type of heat exchanger? Here the hot fluid and the cold fluid flows in terms. Let us say if the hot fluid enters now, after completely heating up the matrix, it will come out of the matrix. After that, the cold fluid will enter, it will completely cool down the matrix and reach and come out. After this, again the hot fluid will heat up the matrix and go out. After that, the cold fluid coming in and heat cooling the matrix and going out. This is how the process will take place in terms of terms. One other example of the rotating, that is a regenerative type of heat exchanger, is rotating matrix type of heat exchanger, where the two heat exchangers are installed over a shaft, and this shaft will be running at very low speed, so that the hot fluid will be entering at this side. By the time it reach this pot, will come down, entire hot fluid goes out, then the cold fluid will come in, and this cold fluid again goes out. This is how the heat transfer will be taking place in case of regenerative, that is rotating matrix type of heat exchanger. Advantage is that we need not stop the workflow. In our previous example, what we are doing, we are stopping the hot fluid for some time and we are sending cold fluid, again we are stopping the cold fluid and again we are sending hot fluid. There is no continuity there. Now here there is a continuity of the fluid flow and there is no starting or stopping of fluid flows. Therefore, this is the advantage of this. One of the practical example of this is the air preheater, which is used in gas turbine power plant, whose name is Jumpstrom air preheater. Now, depending on the direction of flow, this direct transfer type of heat exchangers are further classified. Let us say if both the fluids are flowing in the same direction, then we will call it as a parallel flow. If the fluids are flowing in opposite direction, then we will call it as counter flow. If one fluid is flowing like this and other fluid is flowing like this, then we will call it as cross flow. See here, hot fluid is flowing in this direction. This is the entry point of the hot fluid. This is the exit point of the hot fluid. There is heat exchange taking place between this, and cold fluid is also flowing in the same direction. Therefore, this comes under parallel flow heat exchanger. in counter flow heat exchanger, hot fluid is coming in this direction and the cold fluid is going in this direction, and the temperatures of the hot fluid will decrease, temperature of the cold fluid will increase. In cross flow type of heat exchanger, hot fluids are flowing like this and the cold fluids are flowing like this. There is, these are perpendicular to each other. Shell and tube condensers, automobile radiators are the examples of cross flow heat exchangers. The efficiency of the cross flow heat exchanger is in between the counter and parallel flow. If we talk about which one is more efficient, then the counter flow is more efficient than that of the cross flow. Why, that we will discuss later. Okay, with this we will conclude this lecture. Be motivated, don't lose your hope, always keep practicing, enjoy learning. All the best. Thank you. Here I would like to explain you where exactly the components are installed, that is the accessories are installed. Let us say this is the Rankine cycle, that is modified Rankine cycle, and the hot fluid gas will be coming here and increasing the temperature of the exhaust of the feed water, therefore increasing the boiler efficiency. The temperature of the feed water will increase and rise to boiler temperature. In boiler, the heat transfer will take place and it will used for exchanging heat. Boiler will convert liquid, saturated liquid, into saturated vapor. Therefore the work of boiler is from here to here. After boiler, the stream is sent through the superheated pipes. Again there is a superheater installed here where the hot flue gases will exchange the heat and will further increase the temperature of the steam. This high temperature steam is sent to turbine where expansion takes place. If you want to increase the efficiency of turbine, if you want to increase the output of the turbine further, you can use a reheater here. Again using reheater, after reheater this entire thing is allowed to expand in turbine. This is the, after this is the exit of the turbine, after which it will enter into the condenser. In condenser, the heat exchange will take place between the water, this is the water, and the flowing fluid here, that is steam, which is coming out from the turbine. Okay, this water will get heated up. Temperature entering here is less, temperature at the exit is more. This high temperature is water is sent to cooling tower where there will be spray nozzle, the spray will take place, air will coming. I have explained everything. This water again is supplied here. Okay, this is the exit of the condenser. Again the feed water will be coming. This is how the cycle completes. I hope you understand this.